Okay, guys, so I found this old saw blade lying around. I believe I got it from the mad scientist. But let's see what we can carve in here. Make it a wall hanger. I'm not too sure if I want to take this old rust off or not yet. But anyways, it will be a short video. Just show you if you got an old tool lying around that you don't use it, carve it, and you can give it away as a gift. I'm sure an old timer would love to have this hanging on his in his shop somewhere, you know? Okay. Just to show you guys, I took these bolts out, sorry, screws out with my flathead paint mixer. I can't believe it works for screws too. So it's a lot easier to carve when the handle's off. I just penciled on where the bolts go. Maybe I'll carve some flowers in each one of those. Who knows? I have no idea what I'm going to carve in this yet. I'm just going to start carving and open my mind. Okay guys, when I first started carving this, I was using a little flame tip diamond burr, but I realized that it was just burning the wood. So I switched over to these little detail cutters that I got. Guys, you can follow the link below to get to the link. They'll say detail cutters in the Amazon. So these are wicked little cutters, guys. I just did this in probably, I'd say, about 10 minutes. So one thing I'd like to say, what I wish I would have done first, is I wish I would have taken the old shine off this, you know, because it just kind of interferes when you're carving. Then you got to go back and take it off. It's just best to take like the old lacquer, whatever they put on here, right? It's just best to take it off first and start with a clean slate, just like the bark of the wood, guys. You know, take that off first. So it's only going to be a one-sided carving, okay? Obviously, I'm putting a wood spirit on the handle. That's kind of my thing. So, you know, just to talk about like layering. So these are, I don't know what kind of flowers. They're supposed to be cherry blossoms, but cherry blossoms have five petals. Okay, hold on a second. I need a sip of coffee. Cherry blossoms have five petals, but so these are kind of like dogwoods. So I figured once I seen it like this, then I'm going to put some petals in here. Okay, and I kind of got this idea from my buddy Massey. He's a Japanese guy and he's a wicked artist. And he's a commercial fisherman on and off. And he painted it. Jiffy markered his whole rain jacket. I seen flowers like this and these petals kind of going on there. So that's why I started doing them. I just think it looks super cool. And when I make flowers like this with the petals, I don't care if somebody else has done it, but I call it the Numera flower because his last name's Massey Numera. And I'm going to send him a link to this video and I want him to know that I'm showing other people I got this idea from him. The Numera flower. Now he's on Vancouver Island. Maybe you guys you guys will see him on one of my YouTube videos. So anyways, I'm going to get these quickly drawn out to about here on each side because this guy's going to have hair and this wind's going to be going. I'm going to get these drawn out and then I'll start carving and I'll be back and talk about layering. Okay? Okay, you guys can see I got all my petals drawn on now. See how they're all kind of flowing? They're going to come down here. So what I got now, I don't have a thinner cutter. I do have thinner cutters than this, but this is like just carved raw. He also does a video on layering too. His dragon scale kind of walking stick thing, but I'll try and maybe leave a link to that description below. But he's got a high speed carver and it's run by air. I don't have that, so I have to make do with what I got. So what I'm going to do is with this bit, this is a flame bit, okay? Metalworking burr, guys. It comes from this set again too. I'm going to go all along and cut all these lines out. I'm going to cut my template, okay? All straight up and down. I'm going to just go around and cut all these lines, okay? So I'm going to get that done, and I'll be back, and we'll try and figure out how I can explain layering to you guys if you don't know You know, this is for the beginning carver, don't forget, okay? So I'll be back in about, after cutting all these lines, about 30 billion years, okay? Okay guys, so I got all my lines cut in. So, but remember I was talking about this glossy stuff, it's best just to take it off the beginning, right at the beginning of the piece when you first start. This is why, because now I still got this glossy stuff on each one of these petals. Now I gotta take it off individually, you know? So it just makes it easy to take it off as a full, then take it off as individually. So now I gotta figure out how I'm gonna explain this. Just give me a few minutes. I'll drink some coffee and figure out my way of explaining. Oh yeah, guys, I almost forgot to show you what else I carved today. This guy's name's Big Baby. Look, he's kind of got clown eyes. He comes from the planet of haters. Oh yes, he's just part of my monster challenge. Big Baby, Big Baby the monster, that looks like a clown from planet of haters. Yep. Okay guys, back to carving. So now we want to make these petals look like they're overlapping each other, and this is what I call layering. I don't know if I'm going to explain it the proper way. So what I'm going to do is cut deep on each one of these petals, like cut deep in here and leave this part high, leave the tip of the petal high, and then carve deep in here. Okay, so let me see another example. Okay, right here, see this petal? I'm going to cut deep down here, and I'm going to leave this petal higher. I'm not going to carve this tip of this petal, and I'm going to do that for everything. I think for this part, so you don't listen to all the carving noise, I'm going to just do a few of them and do a little talk through, okay? So, yeah. Okay, guys, so here I am carving deeper in between the two petals. See where the two petals meet back? And cutting it in deeper. This isn't the undercut yet. There's another step to do after this step. So all we're doing is just cutting deeper on the petal's edges. And you know, guys, try and keep everything on point, like where you're doing the petals, because it's really easy to get confused what you've done and what you haven't done if you're real new to this, right? So just cut that petal all lower there. Cut it down farther. Makes the other petals raised above. You see? See how that petal's popping out there? The one on the top right? Now here I am going to the other one. And it's okay to make petals come out from the side, guys, like the side up towards the other petal to make it raised up so it comes. I don't know. I'll just shut up now. Okay, guys. So here we are. Okay, I ended up stripping off all the old varnish. I'm going to leave it original on the backside with this Kutzall burr. This is a less aggressive taper burr. Go to the description below to get to the Kutzalls, guys. Use the code CFUSION to save yourself 5%. But this did a nice job cleaning it up with not leaving too many marks. So now, this point in the carving, when you're doing a layered thing like this, now you can get into something called the undercut. So what the undercut does, in my opinion, it separates each petal. Okay, it separates you. So what you do, you got this little tiny diamond burr, guys. Okay? See this? This is where a high-speed cutter would will come in great effect. And you get these burrs just on Amazon or what your local shop or eBay or whatever, like $7-$10. Okay, but you see this one? Now I'm gonna go along all underneath the petals and do a nice little undercut, because then when you do the under, I don't really want to on this piece, like I really don't care about it too much, but I figured I should do this for the video so you guys can see how doing a nice little undercut underneath, probably about that far under each petal, you including the flower petals, will give it a nice shadow effect, and it will separate the leaves from one another and the petals. Okay, so but after I do that under a cut, you know what I mean? I might have to switch back to my little cutter that I was using and feather away so you don't see the cut lines, if that makes any sense. So let me get doing this and I'll do another talk through, just a few seconds of it, just so you guys. So I'm going to be cutting underneath all the petals everywhere, and it will give them a shadow effect, a little bit better of a shadow effect, but not much. And it will separate, see this? So that's where it looks like it's carved there, you know. You got to separate that line. You got to separate this petal from right there, because it looks like it's just, it's together, you know. But the more that you separate each petal, if I cut that right there, it's going to look way better, in my opinion. Okay, so I'm not going to lie to you guys. That diamond burr, I broke it 2 times, but it acted more like a burner kind of thing. But I did get some undercut there. So I figured, you know, it was working. So I just kept on going with the flow. You know what I mean? You can see them all separated now. Okay. So I got to, I said, this looks all right. So I got this wood burner. Just a cheap one off Amazon, guys. You can find it in the description below. And all I'm going to do now is just turn this sucker on and burn the hell. Not burn the hell, but burn underneath. It's easy to get lost in something like this, guys. So try and remember where you're at. So right now I'm going to do all the flowers first, okay? So I'm just going to burn underneath each flower petal. And this burning actually almost acts as a shadow effect anyways. Well, that's kind of what it's supposed to do. And I believe this is oak wood, guys. This burner does get hot, but just like a few of my friends said, they all get hot. So I'm just going to make sure I do all the flowers first. You guys can probably kind of see it coming to life already, just from this burning. I could have used, I could have went back and took all the undercuts, the undercut marks away with my that little burr, but I don't think I need to. Like, guys, you know, for this channel anyways, for me, I'm never trying to build a friggin' spaceship. Maybe if you want to build a spaceship, you should watch other channels. This is just kind of the basics. And it's just about having fun. Okay, so we got those two flowers. So I got red wood dye too that I've been using quite a bit. So I believe that I'll wood dye these flowers red too. And then I'll use my epoxy shade. Ah, God, I love that stuff. Just give it, you know, just give it a little tap here just to kind of separate your petals. See, there you go. That's what I'm talking about, getting lost. Now, where was I? Okay, so now what I'm going to do is all these petals right here. Let's give it a shot. The burning really does actually give it some nice highlights when your piece is, after you've got your stain on it or whatever. It looks funny for a while, like on wood spirits. But once you get your stain on and stuff like that, I got this wood burning from Just Carve Rob. Because I've seen how cool his pieces can look from doing it. So I figured I'm going to start doing it too. And I started using my diamond burrs from just watching Just Carve Rob too. He does lots of whittling too, guys. So, you know, he's a pretty funny guy. Relaxed. Chill though. Just kind of not give a shit kind of attitude. That's the best attitude to have, I guess. So I'll get this done and then I'll be back. Okay, guys, this is what we got so far. I made sure not to carve any deeper right where those nuts and bolts go with the flathead screwdriver, because I want it to sit nice and flat there, right? So anyways, I'm going to carve this wood spirit using this Kutzall Extreme Flame Burr. Just to block this, no, this is a Kutzall Extreme Taper Burr. Just to block it out quickly, remove lots of bulk. Then I'm going to switch over to these detailed burrs, guys. But if you want to learn how to carve a wood spirit, I got a few in my playlist, step-by-step series on how to carve a wood spirit, my style. So I'm going to do this, I'm going to finish it up, and then we'll get to the dyeing and poly shading. Okay, guys, so this is the piece so far. Okay, so one of my subs was asking, right here I got this mixed up. This is water-based wood dye, okay? This is a red color, but this package is green. But this comes from Lee Valley on in Canada, and they ship worldwide, and they have multiple colors. So if you want to take a screenshot of this, this is the wood dye, water-based, okay? So just Google Lee Valley, and they do ship worldwide. So all I do... Okay, so let's do the flowers first. Okay. So. Guys, these flowers aren't spectacular. I just wanted them to resemble flowers, right? I could have done way more undercuts, but... This piece, I wasn't even planning on even doing this piece today. It just came to my mind. So let me get these dyed done, and then I'll show you what else. Here. Okay, I got the dyeing done good enough. There's a couple bleed outs, like right there. You can see it bleeding on the branches. I don't give a shit. Okay, so I got this. You got to remember, it's water, so you're putting water on this wood. So you got to dry it before you put the poly shade. That's my opinion. I got this heat gun. And I'm just going to dry these flowers off. You can see that bottom one already going brighter because, you know, it's dry. Okay, so those are dry. Dry enough for me anyways. Now I'm going to get the poly shade. Okay, so this is the poly shade that I use. Sorry guys, you can't really see, but this is walnut color, or Mission Oak, sorry. Gloss base, okay? I've been using this on lots of my carvings recently, so let's just soak it on here. Even over top of the red flowers. We'll just soak it on the whole thing. We'll wipe it clean, okay? Yeah, I know, I'm good at wasting stuff. Yep, that's just the way it is, I guess. Okay, I'll get this done and I'll be back. So I'm going to finish this, and I'll show you really quickly. Boom, you can kind of see the effects now. Those flowers are still red. Okay, guys. So you can see it's all done here. The back's done too. So I'm going to hit this lightly. This is a 180 grit. Very soft emery cloth. You can see how I make these old school Dremel flex shaft. You can see how I make these in my play shift. I'm going to hit this really lightly just to make some highlights. Very slow and very lightly. You guys can see those highlights now on that face, like that. There's a brighter spot there now and up here. So let me get this finished and I'll be back. Okay guys, she's done. I just hit the old blade with the just a quick flap sander just to clean it up a bit. I still wanted it to have some of that rustic look, but you know guys, these little burrs here, you can always inscribe some letters into that because these are metalworking burrs, guys. You know what I mean? You can always scribe letters or a saying into this or do whatever you want to do. But here's the handle. So, you know, guys, the only thing that I really switched about it was the screws used to be faced the front. I faced them to the back. I think those, they just look better like flower petal kind of button things in there. So anyways, guys, there it is. What do you guys think? I love to read the comments and, you know, guys, I really like this piece, so I signed it in the front. Lots of my pieces, I signed it on the back, but this one, why not? Just sometimes the pieces that you like, that's the way you can tell. You know, down the road, the ones that you really like, sign in the front. So there it is, guys. I hope you like it, and maybe I hope to see you carve some of these. Don't forget about subscribe if you want, like if you want, share it if you want. And we got a Facebook group called Carving Fusion, World of Wood Carvers, a great support group on there of all new wood carvers and experienced wood carvers. And our live chat, always 5 o'clock Pacific time, Thursday nights. Thanks, guys. And I like it. I think it's cool. I like this guy too. Oh yes. Crybaby. 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 Clown the Crybaby from Planet of Haters.